All right, our next guest is Christian Rutter. He's the president and co-founder of the dating website. One of the biggest dating websites out there is called OkCupid, and he's written a new book called Dataclism, Who We Are. Christian Rutter, welcome to the Big 550 KTRS.
Hey, thanks. I'm glad to be here.
All right, so explain to us, what is the premise of Dataclism?
Well, you know, I started OkCupid with a couple friends, three friends, like 10 years ago, and we spent all this time looking at all the data of what people were doing to figure out, you know, who they wanted to have sex with, who they hated, who they just wanted to date, what, you know, describing themselves, all this stuff. And I realized that people at Facebook and Twitter were probably doing the same kinds of things to find out what their users were doing. And so I wrote this book to tie all that stuff together to kind of tell the sort of human interest side of data that wasn't about money or about spying or any of these things, and just kind of look at how people are living their lives online.
Yeah, a couple of the things you find interesting. First of all, what is this that attractive women receive more interview requests?
Yeah, well, on OkCupid, obviously, if you're hot, you get a lot more attention. But we found that for women on a job site, even the kind of they get the same amount of, they're treated as if they're on a dating site. So being hot kind of exponentially affects your job prospects on the site that I looked at, just like it exponentially affects your dating prospects. Whereas for men on a dating site, being hot is also good, but on a job site, it doesn't matter at all. So it's very interesting to see, like, women applying for jobs are basically treated like they're on a date, and guys are, I assume, looked at on their professional credentials.
So is it as dirty as they just want to meet the cute girl, or does the cute girl end up getting the job more?
I only looked at interview requests, so I don't know the outcome. I imagine there's probably a little bit of both. I'm sure there's some dirt to it,
right?
Like anything online.
What about this that you to have haters on the internet, and there are a lot of haters out there?
Oh God, yeah, that's definitely true.
It's better to be hot and good looking.
Well, the result was that on OkCupid, if you have something that's kind of divisive about your look, you know, if you have a tattoo or kind of maybe a kind of bigger nose than normal, or a gap in your teeth, or a crazy color of hair, or something like this, there's going to be people that really hate it. But that same thing, the thing that makes people hate it, also makes some people really love it, and that actually nets you more attention, more dates, than somebody who has a kind of like middle of the road look that's still very attractive, but just doesn't have that kind of exceptional thing that can kind of drive people away and pull people in.
Let me ask you. Are people more honest when they're anonymous or when they're under their real name? Because I find on Facebook, a lot of people who are really vicious, but they don't give their real names.
Yeah, that's a pretty common thing. I mean, I definitely looked at kind of both sides of that. People, especially in the book, I looked at what people are doing, not necessarily what people say they're doing or how people talk about themselves. I looked at, you know, you ask people who are looking for a date, does race matter? You know, is interracial marriage okay? They'll say, oh, no, of course, it's all fine. I'm open-minded. They have a kind of politically correct, open-minded outlook. And then you go look at what they're doing. Race is a huge factor in what people find attractive. And just like on Facebook, too, I look at what people are doing, what they're actually liking, who they're friends with, rather than kind of like what they're claiming about themselves, and that alleviates some of the problem. But unquestionably, the kind of like cover of anonymity is a big problem online.
People, what have you found about Twitter and the outrage that you see on Twitter on a second-by-second basis?
You know, we've all seen the kind of like firestorms that can get generated on Twitter, but I think I didn't really appreciate the incredible scope and speed of which these things move. I mean, it's literally like a forest fire out in the Rockies or something. There was I looked at a few cases of people who had tweeted either bad jokes or suspect things, very dicey, kind of racially questionable content in some of these examples. And in the speed at which that blows up, and there was one woman who her tweet was called down in front of 60 million people in the first 24 hours, which is just crazy for a tweet. I mean, you can say offensive things, and that's bad, but it's just that the scale of outrage just kind of is out of proportion to what's actually at the middle of it. You know?
But have you found, Christian Rutter, the book is called Dataclism, have you found that to get that type of speed and that retweeting and those, you know, video hits, you have to be more and more outrageous, right?
Right, and that's what drives people to kind of put their foot in their mouth sometimes, is people want, you want audience, you know, people treat themselves like a brand more and more now, you know, people want to go viral, not just some web company want virality, but people want to go viral themselves, you know, and that can cut both ways. I mean, you could suddenly have some amazing picture or GIF or whatever, and it is trending on Twitter, and that's great. But then you can also have something that's trending in a bad way.
Yeah.
I got to ask you about your own website, OkCupid.
Sure.
What's the number one thing that people really lie about? Is it their age? I mean, is it their income or their looks?
Kelly's asking for more than one reason.
Well, people can't lie about their looks. That's all user measured. So unless you're photoshopping your photo, which is pretty rare, people definitely lie about their income. I went and looked, and I think OkCupid, according to our users, has more millionaires than actually exist in the United States. So that's kind of nobody tell the IRS, right? And then there's guys kind of uniformly add 2 inches to their height. So in the book, I made it just because I know people like to lie about themselves. You know, unless it was to examine lies like this, I really tried to stay away from what people just claim is true, and I looked at what they're doing.
Yeah. How did you figure out who people bathe more in, Vermont or New Jersey?
Well, that is a kind of silly example of me taking people at their word, where we ask people thousands of questions about themselves, trying to bring them together. You know, stuff like, do you believe in God? Do you,
right.
You know, all of the kind of things that you can imagine a dating site wants to know. And one of the questions is, how often do you shower? And Vermonters and people who live in Oregon shower by far the least of other Americans.
All right, fair enough.
I'm from the Mid-South myself. I'm from Arkansas. I'm from Little Rock. So, you know, I know how hot it can get. And you just, in the South is the most showered place in the country for sure. And I think that's why, is that you go outside, you know, in the summer and you just break a sweat. You gotta cool off.
Christian Rutter, the book is Dataclysm. One quick question for you. With all this information out there, this is where the marketers are using it to their advantage to sell us everything they're trying to sell us.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I probably have the same feelings about that I assume many of your listeners do. Like, I'm not that excited when I see an ad for body spray or Skittles or whatever it is in my Twitter or my Facebook feed. And that's kind of why I wrote the book. Like, I feel like that kind of marketing is fine, but it also bothers people. And I wanted to kind of show the more interesting side of things. You know, talk about sex and race and love and all the stuff that's not dollars that I think most people just find more pertinent to their lives.
Yeah. The book is Dataclysm, Who We Are When We Think No One's Looking. Christian Rutter, the founder of OkCupid. Christian, be safe. Thanks for checking in.
Hey, my pleasure. Thank you.
7:58.